Hi, let's talk about the embedded order data, or EOD, import integration in Alma. EOD files can be imported into Alma to create purchase orders, PO lines, and inventory records. You can choose to do this by uploading files or connecting to an FTP location. The relevant bibliographic data and purchase order information is extracted from the mark fields and subfields in the EOD records that come from your vendor. This process automates acquisitions and cataloging workflows, saving library staff time. Let's take a look at how to configure this integration. You'll start by creating an import profile, which you can do by going to the Acquisitions menu and selecting Manage Import Profiles. From here, click Add New Profile and choose New Order as the profile type. I'm going to create an import profile specifically for my orders of physical materials from Baker & Taylor. So I'll give it a name that makes it easy to identify, then select Baker & Taylor as the originating system. Indicate how you plan on importing the file. Will it be manually uploaded or connecting via FTP? If you select FTP, you'll be prompted to enter the information for the FTP server you have configured in Alma. For this demonstration, we are going to select Upload Files. Note that there are many options available when setting up a new import profile. We will cover the basics in this demonstration and will end the session with a list of additional resources that include the more advanced features of a profile. You have the option to use filters and normalization rules, but for this profile, I know I will want everything to be imported as is. Next, you've got options for how you want Alma to handle records that match a record that already exists in the system. The default settings handle the process of matching records automatically and instruct Alma to not import any records that match an existing record. We are going to stick with the default settings for this demonstration. There is also the option to suppress records from being discoverable in Primo. For example, if you don't want patrons to be able to place a hold on a book that still needs to go through processing, this option will allow you to keep the record suppressed until it is shelf ready. You can also choose to publish your bibs or holdings to OCLC and/or Libraries Australia. Now you will indicate the format of your orders, physical, electronic, or mixed. Here you can configure which mark fields can be used to provide the listed data. If you don't fill these in, Alma will select default options. I'm setting this profile up for physical orders, which includes two useful fields, the library and location fields and subfields. Fill in where they can be found, for example, 049 subfield A and 049 subfield B. Finally, you'll indicate the type of purchase order line that you wish to create for this vendor. I'm choosing physical item one time. There are lots of options for mapping information. Look up the embedded order data field mapping table for detailed information about each of these fields. When you're done filling in the purchase order parameters, click Save. And now we can see our new profile. You can run the import job by selecting Run from the Action menu. Now we can go back into Alma and look at an example of imported files. It's an incredible time saver. To learn more about EOD import, we refer you to these further resources. In the Ex Libris Learning Center, you can find an in-depth session entitled Importing Bibliographic Records with Embedded Order Data. You can also watch parts 1 and 2 of the import profile videos found in the acquisition section of the Alma Administration Certification Training. In case of an import from multiple vendors, we refer you to the Multiple Vendors in EOD Import File session. And in the Alma Online Help, you can learn more by searching for EOD Import.